Welcome back, everybody. Today is the day for the Star Wars Force Awakening movie premiere. We just want to give quick shout-outs to
our
subscribers, likers, and our viewers. Honey from Honey's World, top-notch. Thanks for liking. Thanks for subscribing.
One of our friends, Swaybar.
Swaybar, awesome, awesome. I heard you got a beer for us. Bring it back.
Hopefully soon.
And our other brother, Warren. Thanks for watching all of our videos. But again, welcome back to Drinks for Geeks. I'm Hammer.
And I'm Max.
And here we go. We have a beer today just for the Force Awakens movie. We've only got like an hour to get to it. So we're going to make this quick. Hope you enjoy it, and I think we got a good beer for it. So, show it, Axe.
It's a San Miguel Red Horse beer.
I heard it's pretty damn good. It's got some alcohol on it too, doesn't it?
Oh yeah, wow. 8% by volume. God damn, that's a strong beer for a 12-ounce bottle.
It's a remanufactured beer out of Irvine, California, but it is a Samuel Miguel's out of the Philippines. So it's a premium, like it's one of their most premium beers they've got.
I guess.
It's delicious from what I hear. It has a very, very smooth taste, but let's taste it out and let's do it. The bottle, it looks like a very typical premium beer. It's got it's a 12-ounce bottle, paper labels, brown bottle. But it has almost like red and gold look to it, which is actually kind of cool. Kind of resembles the Sith colors. Oh, and I got my Stormtrooper cover. Yeah.
Oh, that is a really...
Wow. Okay.
Light.
I would like to say it looks very like a lager.
Thinking the same thing.
I think this is a lager. See how clear this looks? So what actually makes most lagers and ales is one, it's the roasting of the hops and the barley. The longer and darker the roast takes, it changes the color, and then the lower they roast it, the color is on a lighter scale. So looks like they didn't roast their hops or barley very long for this one. But nice color.
Straight
though.
To the beer.
Yep. Oh, that smell. Very mellow smell.
Really? Smell like your typical average everyday beer.
Yeah, there's
something there,
there's
but
something
it's
there,
nothing.
Though. I don't know what that is.
It's the alcohol.
Yes, it doesn't. I think this is a lager. I have to go back and look at it, but it has that lagery smell. I mean, very, very low. Actually, barely any head to it.
See through it.
You can see through it. So, I mean, smell, probably a 4, not really much smell. Yeah. It looks nice, though. I give the look about a 7.
But it looks like one of those creeping beers that your alcohol just kicks you at the end. It's just so damn clear.
Yeah. In fact, trivia. What does Darth Vader mean? If anybody can tell me what Darth Vader means in the comment below, I'll give you a hint. He has a famous line in his one movie, and Vader might be part of it. Also another hit. Hint, it's German. But that's the most I can give you. If you can figure, if you tell me what that is, that'd be cool. Because he has an awesome Darth Vader ship right now. But Drinks for Geeks, what we do best is taste the beer. Ooh. I've said this many of times. This is definitely a lager. This is it needs to be a little bit more chilled.
Yeah, I would have to agree with that. A little bit.
We've had it in the, I say, the freezer for maybe a little less than 20 minutes, but lagers do taste better when they're actually on the very colder end. I actually like this beer, but it's a bit strong.
Slight
on the,
bite.
On the warmer end, yeah.
There's a slight bite to it. And it's not the alcohol bite. It's,
no, the, it's not the alcohol.
The flavor's got a slight bite to it.
But very mellow. It's I would say it's definitely a premium beer. It's very mellow. Nice taste.
This would be something you could drink any day of the week, actually.
True that, yeah. This is a drinkable beer. Casual, party town, video games, movies. In fact, this is a good movie for a good beer for Star Wars.
Oh, yeah.
It's the Red Horse, everybody. I'd probably say this is actually a good beer from San Miguel. Very, very good beer.
I haven't actually had a San Miguel in a very long time.
Yeah.
So, taste bud-wise, I don't have nothing to compare it to on the standard San Miguel, but this actually
is on the warmer end, it is a bit strong, though. I would recommend it being chilled.
Yeah, a lot longer, because there's no frost on this glass. It's still see-through.
Yeah.
It's not bad, though.
But it's a good beer. It's a premium beer. I don't know. I'd probably give it off just to taste alone. I say, wow, it might actually go ranking up there with the IPAs and some of our stouts. I'd say maybe a 7.5. Pretty close to an 8. Smell probably needs to change, but other than that, it's a typical
lager beer. Yeah, I think so. Other than the scent, for me, I'd maybe give it about 7.
Yeah, I've had lagers that had a lot of smell to it, but I can't really decipher and tell you the exact smell to it. I mean, it smells like a beer. It doesn't taste like your normal draft beer, though. It's smoother. It's, I'd say, even almost untasty, but that's a good thing because anybody can actually drink this. As long as you're 21 years over, I mean, and you're not used to most beers, actually, that's a really good beer to kind of bring somebody into the whole real beer realm.
You know what, too? Price-wise on this thing wasn't that bad.
Oh, yeah, what's the price on this?
$8 for a six-pack.
That's not bad.
That wasn't that bad.
That's not bad.
And considering you're going to get 6 bottles worth of 8% alcohol, so yeah.
Yeah. I say for the lagers, this
might be the beer you're looking for.
Yeah, this is the beer you were looking for. That's probably the best lager I've done a review on. Of all the reviews we've done so far, that's awesome. And in fact, that's probably the best beer we've had in maybe this whole...
I think so.
Yeah. Force Awakening saga we've been doing right now.
Yeah. I think I kind of got to agree with that one. I mean, aside from the alcohol content on some of the other ones, this one actually is a lot more drinkable. Yeah. You could drink more of it without worrying about, you know, denting your pocket.
Yep.
That's too bad.
But I will say, what are our expectations, I would say, for the upcoming movie, since that's what the whole reason why we're doing these videos for, was for the Force Awakens Star Wars movie. I think we're going to go in it as, I mean, I'm not going to put words in Axe's mouth, but at least I would say no expectation. So, anything is going to be better than part 1, 2, and 3. Not 4, 5, 6, guys. Part 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah, we saw 4, 5, and 6 first. We grew up in that era.
But my expectations? No. None.
Yeah.
I'm just going to go in it, enjoy it, and watch it, and possibly watch it again. And again, and again.
All I want is a lightsaber battle. It will be awesome.
Heck yeah.
All I want is a lightsaber battle. It will be awesome.
Another one. Post movie though, yep, so
definitely.
Hopefully, there's a lot of action. Again, it's not expectations, but hopefully, there's a lot of action. A lot of, I guess, Jedi Sith action.
Hopefully,
there's a lot of Sith going on. But other than that, I mean, hey, welcome back again to Drinks for Geeks, and we drink it
so you don't have to
unless you like it. To everybody who subscribed, thanks again. 50 to 100 subscribers! Yee! Thanks,
guys. Remember, 50 subscribers, you want me to chug a beer? Remember that one.
Thanks, guys.